Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA on the Windows operating system. So, let's begin. Now to install the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA on the Windows operating system, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and in that this word, you need to just simply search with IntelliJ IDEA download and hit enter. And it will going to show you this www.jetbrains.com as our first search result. So here you need to just simply click on download IntelliJ IDEA. And when you click on that, it's going to redirect to the official site of jetbrains.com. So here you can see we have option download IntelliJ IDEA. So it is available for Windows, Mac OS and Linux. So depending upon what operating system you are using, you need to switch to those tab. I'm going to switch it to for Windows. And here we have two options, one is Ultimate, another is the Community one. I'm going to download the Community one. And when you click on that, it's going to show you, thank you for downloading IntelliJ IDEA. And it has rightly started downloading our IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition. Now since I have already downloaded it, I'll just simply cancel it. I'll minimize my browser. And when I go to my download directory, you can see we have IntelliJ IDEA Community 2022.3.3 is rightly downloaded over here. And if you see the file size, it is 646 MB. Okay, so now to install, you need to just simply double click on the installer and it's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. And you can see, welcome to IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition Setup. So this is our installation wizard. You can minimize your download directory. So here you need to just simply click on next. So this is our destination folder where it's going to be installed. So in our C drive, in our program files, it's going to create our JetBrains folder. And on that JetBrains folder, it's going to create IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition 2022.3 folder over here, where it's going to be installed. Okay. And you can see we need 2.7 gigabyte of free space on our C drive. And currently we are having 39.1 gigabyte, which is totally fine. So just simply click on next, and under installation options, you can see you have some options. So here, first one is you need to check this IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition setup. So what that basically means is it's going to create a desktop shortcut. So you can see here we have PyCharm Community Edition. So similarly, it's going to create one for IntelliJ IDEA. Okay, and you can also check this add open folder as project. So all that basically means is if you have a project somewhere, so that project is related to your Java where IntelliJ IDEA supports. So on just simply right clicking that, it's going to show you this open folder as project. So you can directly open that folder in our IntelliJ IDEA. So for that, you need to check this option. And this is our associated languages which supports IntelliJ IDEA. So if you are into Java, you need to choose Java. In this video, I'm going to show you about Java. Or if you want to code in Groovy, Kotlin, then you need to proceed with these options. Okay, you need to check this, that's all. And here you need to also check this add bin folder to path. So all that basically mean is it automatically going to set our environment path in our environment variables. That's a very important step. And you need to also restart your system. I'm going to show you that place where when you need to restart. Okay, for now, just simply select all this and click on next. So as I have mentioned, it's going to create this JetBrains folder, which is totally fine. Click on install and there you go. You can see our installation has rightly begun and it has also created our desktop shortcut IntelliJ IDEA Community. Okay, so let's wait for a couple of minutes to get it finish installing our IntelliJ IDEA on our local system. So after that, I'll be again coming back to this video. Yep. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see it is telling completing IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition setup. So here it is telling whether you'd like to reboot your system now or you'd like to manually reboot later. So here I'll recommend you to check this reboot now. So once you reboot your system, our IntelliJ IDEA is going to be installed on your system properly. So just simply click on reboot now and click on finish. And after rebooting your system, I'll be again coming back to this video. So after successfully restarting your system, you are again back to our desktop. So here you can see we have the shortcut IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition 2022.3. So just simply double click on the shortcut to launch our IntelliJ IDEA, and it will ask you whether you like to import IntelliJ IDEA settings. So this is for all installations. If you have done anything previously, then you need to choose this configure installation directory, or else you can just simply proceed with do not import settings. Click on OK, and there you go. You can see our IntelliJ IDEA 2022.3 is rightly launched. So welcome to IntelliJ IDEA. Before that, it will ask you to give allow access for, you know, Windows Defender firewall. You can click on allow access, and there you go. Welcome to IntelliJ IDEA. So this is our interface. You can maximize it. So, you know, this is our interface. You can just simply click on new project in order to create a new project, and it's going to start detecting our JDK. So if you haven't installed Java previously, it's going to install now, or else if you have Java installed previously, then it automatically going to recognize that. Over here you can see our JDK is rightly recognized. So if you don't have Java installed previously, you can just simply click on download JDK, and it's going to automatically download your JDK. Okay, so from internet. So only thing is, you need to have active internet connection for that. Okay, here you can give your project name. I'm going to give Hello Coders, and all other things are fine. Java is selected, IntelliJ IDEA, our Java is also found. Add a sample code, click on create, and it's going to start creating our project. So here is our Hello Coders project. Okay, you can maximize it. And here is our, you know, main class. Just simply double click on it, and you can see our main public class main is rightly created over here. This is our main method, public static, you know, string args. And here is our system.out.println code. So we are printing hello world over here. So you can see it is indexing. So once our indexing get finished, it's going to enable our this run button. So let's wait for it to get finished. And you can see that our indexing has rightly finished. So you can just simply click on this run button in order to build our project. And you can see that our build has been successful. So it has rightly printed hello world over here. So in this way, you can easily install the latest version of IntelliJ IDEA on Windows operating system. So that's basically all about this video. If you face any difficulty in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'm always there to help you. So please do subscribe. That will really help me to make more such videos. So that's pretty much all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.